or Mad Bike magazines, Fire Racks in Wrexham. They've kindly lent us the state-of-the-art dyno rig for a full wet and dry run test on all the current disc brakes we can get our hands on. Currently we're going through the bedding in process on Formula's R1 brake. Each brake we're testing uses a fresh rotor and a completely fresh brake to avoid contamination, make sure there's no bleeding issues. And each brake goes through a 10-cycle bedding in process, 4 seconds on, 30 seconds off, with a 50 newton metre pull. The newton metre pull is recorded on this hydraulic ram up here. Jack's on the lever here. Like that. As the brake is applied, there's also a downward force at the front wheel, which is equivalent to a 100 kilo rider, and the braking force is there to, but I shouldn't have stood up, so you can't see my head. So as soon as we've done the 10 runs on the bedding in process, we go straight into the brake testing. And we're testing with incremental lever pull from 50 newton meters, 3 pulls, get an average power and stopping distance, then moving up to 100 newton meters for another 3 pulls, then 150 newton meters for another 3 pulls, which is our maximum braking force measurement. We then switch on the sprinklers and run through the whole system again to give wet readings as well. So we're dyno testing the brakes from the whole range of conditions they're likely to see on the trail. So this is the first of the braking runs on the Formula. 50 newton meters, dry conditions, 3 pulls. This is where we should have had some music.
Thank you.